Welcome to the third video in the Project Fundamentals series. In this video, we will explore how to elevate your product launch by collecting critical data with cell linking, automating insights using formulas, and generating current user reports tailored to your team. Let's get started. Use cell linking to bring key data from your intake sheet to your project plan sheet. In your project plan sheet, start by adding a new row at the top of your sheet and naming it Project Info. Then let's add three child rows with the key data we want to pull in from the intake sheet. To create a cell link, right-click in the cell, then select Link from Cell in Other Sheet. Find your source sheet, in this case, our project intake sheet. Then select the field we want to cell link. Select Create Link. Now the project ID appears, and the blue arrow in the cell indicates the data is input through a cell link. Repeat this process to bring in the request and assign a field from the intake sheet. Cell linking helps your project data stay consistent with one main source of truth. Now let's use formulas on our project plan sheet to help us quickly find valuable insights. In the project plan sheet, add a parent row labeled summary and then child rows that we will use formulas to fill out. In the cell next to project status, enter an equal sign. The equal sign is how Smartsheet knows you are entering in a formula. We want to pull the project status from row 10. Select the cell on row 10 with the project status. Now this cell is referenced in the formula. Select Enter to see the status now appear in the summary as well. Next, let's write a count ifs formula to tell us how many tasks we have that are incomplete with a due date in the past. Type an equals sign. Type count ifs. This function looks in a particular range and counts only the rows that match the criteria. Our first range is our end date column. Put the column name in brackets and separated by a colon to tell the formula to look at the entire column. Then our criterion is any date less than today. Use the less than arrow and the today function. Then enter a comma to move to our next range and criterion. Now we want to count tasks that are incomplete. Our range is the entire status column. Our criterion is any status except for complete. The less than and greater than arrows together mean not equal to. Then type complete in quotations. Close the parentheses to finish your formula. Hit Enter and our formula returns 4. That means there are 4 rows that have a due date in the past and are not yet completed. Next, fill in the other 2 formulas. We also want to count the number of incomplete tasks that are high priority. And we want to count the number of tasks due this week. Now we can use the summary section of our project plan sheet to quickly find key data. Next, let's look at custom reports. Smartsheet reports provide tailored views to track progress, analyze data, and align teams. There are 2 report types, row reports and sheet summary reports. Row reports pull data from sheets based on filters such as deadlines or status. You can configure the filters to only show data for the current user, which makes them very powerful. Sheet summary reports pull data from the sheet summary section of sheets, making them helpful in sharing high-level overview data. Let's configure a row report first. Select Add, then select Report, then Row Report. Choose Sheets, then OK. Choose the sheets you want to pull data from. In this case, we'll use the project plan for our first project. Select OK. Pick the columns you want displayed on the report. Select OK. You can add multiple filters, but for now, let's make this report show tasks assigned to the current user. Select Assign To. Select Has All Of. Choose Current User, then select OK. Our report shows the tasks from the first project assigned to whichever user is viewing the report. If we want to organize our report, we can group the rows based on any columns from our sheet. Let's group our report by task status. Select Group. Then open the drop-down list of columns and select Status. You can also organize the rows in the groups in ascending or descending order. We will leave the report in the default ascending order. Next, select OK. Now your report is grouped by status, making it easy to find the tasks that need your attention first. Another helpful feature is the Summarize tool. We can use that to count, sum, or average various data in our report. Let's get a count of how many tasks are in each group. Select Summarize. Open the drop-down menu and select Status. Then, in the next drop-down menu, select Count. Finally, choose OK. Now you can quickly see how many tasks fall into each group. Now let's create a sheet summary report. Select Add, then Report, then Sheet Summary Report. Now we need to select our sheets to pull the summary data from. Let's choose all of the project plan sheets. Select Next. Then we can pick the fields to display. We only want high-level data, so let's choose status, start date, and end date. Select Next. Now we have our summary report that we can utilize when creating dashboards for our project. This consolidated view will provide valuable insights and seamlessly integrate with your dashboards, showcasing Smartsheet's ability to scale from detailed task management to high-level project overviews. By automating insights with cell linking and formulas and creating personalized reports, you've established a streamlined system to keep your product launch organized and on schedule. Dive into the reporting learning track to learn more. Thanks for watching.